So far, so good. Let's try sport mode 2. Changing up again. Now this has been sitting in third gear for quite a long time. There you go. I suppose that's sport mode for you. I'm trying this out with an external microphone on. I've never used it out front before. I've normally got it buried in the bag, but I thought I'd do a bit of talking on the video because I've been accused of making boring videos by young Dave Rowe, who requested a video in the first place. So there's a good chance this is going to sound absolutely wanky when I play it back, in which case I'll probably just have to play a bit of music over it, or I don't know, maybe just turn the volume down altogether on the parts where I've been talking and just leave you with the non-talking parts. But it's all a learning curve. For the time being, let's open it up a bit. Fucking hell, that really is long gear changes. Might change that down to sport one in a bit and see how that goes. DCT is a bit funny, it's not as smooth as I thought it was going to be. I've got it in sport mode 2, which the dealer recommended is a sort of happy medium between not overly sporty, so you can still use it at slow speeds like this, but it's not as ludicrous as the drive mode, where I was in fifth gear at about 22 miles an hour and felt like I was riding a jackhammer, having ridden a jackhammer the previous summer. But no, this is quite nice. It's certainly something I could get used to. I'm going to open it up a bit now that we're out of the 30 mile an hour zone. It does sit in third gear quite a long time. I might change down to sport one and see if that makes a difference. So I'm not sure if you can do on the move or not. So let's give it a whirl. Sport three, it's much worse. Let's try sport one. Ah, that's a bit better. All right, track. Yeah, sport one is definitely more to my liking. Certainly suits the way I ride a bit better. With lower down gear changes, it feels much more mellow than sport two. Still very clunky though on the gear changes. To be honest, I thought it would feel a lot smoother. But maybe it's just something you get used to. Up to a faster bit of road now, so I think I'm going to try my hand at Sport 3. See how it goes. Sport 3, there you go. Visor down. Plus 70 there, and I didn't go above fourth gear, so I think I'm going to try it on Sport 2, see how that goes. Can't fucking change it now. Go too mental because it is very wet out and I do not own this bike. Screen does a really good job of keeping the wind off your face. I can ride at 70 easy with my visor wide open and I'm not getting any wind or rain in the face, so that's really good. The first bike I'll ever own that I don't have to buy an aftermarket screen, I think. Let's give it another go. Sport 2. Nice and stable at slow speeds like that. One of my big concerns was that without the clutch control, you might feel a bit all over the place at going at those slow speeds, but the engine does a really good job of keeping you level. Thank you. The suspension on it's not great. It does feel a bit hard on the back. It's not up there with the Africa Twin, which I suppose is why the Africa Twin costs so much more. The Africa Twin is a really sweet ride, whereas this feels a little bit harsh. lovely handling bike though. It's not as nice as the Tiger 660 Sport, which I tried a couple of weeks ago. But considering how much bigger and heavier this bike is, it certainly doesn't feel like a heavy bike when you ride it. It's a very similar feeling to my NC750X. Low speeds, 20-30 miles an hour, it feels like a lovely bike. It's not just been made for motorways. And considering how much more this bike costs than the NC, there's not a lot of difference in it. It handles very similar. This feels like a bit of a bigger bike, but I wouldn't say the suspension feels any better. Both feel a bit harsh on the bumps. This has a bit more power, but to be honest, not as much as you'd think. Even in Sport 3, it's got a lot of torque, but then so does the NC. I suppose the NC just peters out a bit faster than this one does. But considering you can get yourself an NC750X for around about $7,000, I don't think there's a lot in it, to be honest. I know some people probably hear that and think I'm crazy, but just my first impressions, it doesn't seem much more comfortable than my bike. Seems a bit more powerful, but not a lot. The brakes, maybe the brakes are a bit better. Maybe being a DCT makes a difference. Maybe if I had a manual bike that I was more comfortable riding, maybe I could really get a bit more out of the engine and just see where all that extra power is. Also, it's a damp day, so I don't want to go crazy. But I wasn't expecting a lot of power out of it. That's not what this engine is about. If I wanted that, I'd go for, a Versys 1000 or something similar. But I'm surprised how similar it is to my NC750X. If you get an ad at the end of this video offering my NC750X for sale, you know I'm full of shit. Doesn't feel as smooth as my NC because that little engine is not going to be as vibey as a big 1100 like this, but I can feel the tingles in my right hand a little bit, which I don't feel on my bike. But hey, who knows, maybe I'm just having a stroke or a heart attack. Which one gives you tingles? Actually, I haven't ridden it a bit longer, I'm lying to myself. The bag's more powered than the NC. I don't know what I was even thinking about. Very nice. this one more time before we get on the motorway.